Hello, everybody. My name is Victor, and welcome back to Balatro here on the channel. Well, sorry about not having a video yesterday. There was some craziness going on. For those of you who don't follow me on Twitter, or if you're not in the Discord, you're not going to know what's going to happen. But basically, there was some YouTube copyright stuff that had to be taken care of, and that basically wiped out my entire day because I had to deal with that. So I do apologize about that. Yeah, since the last video, I don't remember exactly what we were doing in the last video, but I have unlocked a bunch of different decks here, including the Anaglyph deck, which I've not actually used before, but I'm still trying to get my first win here on, where's that deck one? Yeah, well, I guess we should play it. So after defeating the boss blind, gain a double tag. So yeah, let's just go ahead and try it. This is my first time ever playing it here. Really quickly, I have updated my collection as well. Again, I'm not going to click on these because I don't want to spoil anyone who's watching, but I am almost fully unlocked, which I'm pretty happy about. I've been spending a lot of time on stream trying to get stuff done, and yeah, and thank you all very much, of course, for the continued support. And also, one final time, sorry about not having a video yesterday. It was a bad day. So another thing that people were asking in the comments is that I kind of slow down whenever I'm making plays. Talking about synergies and everything, I will definitely slow down a little bit, but these runs are already starting to get pretty dang long, so I don't necessarily want to like increase the length, but I will do a better job at explaining like, hey, why are you doing this, why are you doing that, you know, and not just kind of just play mindlessly here. So very good start here with clearance sale. It's basically like a half Steam sale. All cards and packs in the shop are 25% off. I do like Smiley Face. Every played face card gives +4 multi. Square Joker, I've never really gotten to get off the ground here, so definitely clearance sale to start off with, especially since we have $10 at the opening bid here. All right, so we can reroll the boss blind here if we skip. The Manacle is annoying, but I don't think we have to really worry about it too much. At least I hope not anyway. Starting off with a King High Flush. I don't see any reason not to play that there. It's not going to get us all the way. It's going to get us to almost 300. But yeah, this is no big deal. Of course, we're keeping our discards here. Could go for a full boat. We've already drawn. So really quickly, to explain stuff, because a lot of people who have not played the game before are trying to get into the Balatro series, and I'll do a better job at explaining some of the basic stuff. For those of you who aren't like already caught up and they're like, oh yeah, you should do this, this is blah, 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 blah. You're just trying to understand how to play the game. So basically what you have is you have a number that you're supposed to beat, which is up here, the blind. This is the number of hands that you can play. This number of discards you have, pretty self-explanatory. This will show you a readout of exactly how many points you have, as well as readout of the type of poker hand. And then of course your round score. The objective is for your round score to beat the blind. Antes over here, this is where Balatro gets in a little bit of issues with the wording. Antes are basically, think of them like Isaac floors, okay? So we are on ante one, so we're on floor one. If you look at the blinds here, you can see it here, we've only fought one, and then we have two more. Well, actually, we fought both of them after this one. Once we beat the Manacle, we go on to ante two, then it's ante two, 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 beat the boss, ante three, four. So think of antes like they are the floors in Isaac. The round represents how many blinds you have fought. Okay, so if we were to skip the Manacle here, or if we were to have skipped the big blind and then went straight to the Manacle, we would be on round two instead of round three. If we'd skip both of these and then fought the Manacle, we would be on round one. Does that make sense? So again, the wording in the game is a little bit ambiguous, especially if for those of you who have actually played poker like I have, but just know that that's if you think of them that way, then a lot of stuff will be very less confusing for you. We're gonna play ace high flush. This should get us there, and it did. So now that the round score is over, we beat the big blind, and then we cash out. You get $1 for every remaining hand that you've not used. So in some cases, in most cases, you are encouraged to try to get out with as few hands as played as possible to maximize your money. It's not always going to work out like that. There are some builds where it actually helps you with the amount of discards that you have left over, but we don't have that build. So for the shop here, we have a to-do list. Earn $5 if a poker hand is a straight flush. We're just going to ignore that. Mystic Summit, you get +15 multi when zero discards remain. It's a pretty decent... This is a pretty decent joker, but not here. Definitely not for our first. Especially with the manacle coming up, we might use it, but I always go for spectral packs because they can just be absolutely insane. Choose one or two spectral cards, be used up immediately. We have Incantation, which is going to destroy one random card in your hand and add four enhanced numbers to your number cards to your hand. Or we destroy one random card and we get an enhanced face card. I always like to go with face cards because they're worth more chips. So let's go for familiar. Hopefully we destroy like a deuce or something over here. I didn't see it. I think we destroyed an 8 or a 9, something like that. So we also go for a celestial pack. Celestial packs are used to basically level up your hands. At the base level here, you see that everything is level 1. If you mouse over, you can see exactly what type of poker hands there are. I'm not going to explain how to play poker. If you have any questions about how to like start playing poker or whatever, there's many, 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 many beginner's guides on how to play poker. It's a very, very simple game. Which can get more complicated, obviously. So, this level one over here represents how many levels we've unlocked, or leveled up a certain hand. So, for example, we only have a level one high card, so we're going to get the minimum of 5 points at the base level. And every time we raise the level of a hand, it's going to raise the base stats of the hand. Okay, so then it goes up to like 10 chips times 2, or you know, 20 chips times 3, and so forth. It doesn't scale like that, but I'm just giving an example. This number over here represents how many times we've actually played it. So as you can see, we played a flush 3 times. Flushes tend to be very, very common in Balatro, and also a very strong build. It's way better than straights as well. So here are our celestial or planetary cards here. This one levels up full house. This one levels up flush. This one levels up 3 of a kind. You don't have to level up the one that you use all the time, but flushes are really, really solid. So as you see here, it's going to give +2 to the multi and +15 chips to the base level of flushes. So now instead of our flushes being 35 chips times 4 at the base level, this is now going to make it to 50 times 4. 50 times 6, I mean. There you go. So we're definitely encouraged to play flushes here. We have 3 clubs. We have nothing else, so definitely want to go for flushes. We do have 2 nines, but I'm not going to worry about that. We get an A-side flush. Very nice. This should be... I don't think this is going to be enough, but it should be decent with the extra chips. Yeah, no problem. There you go. So you saw the ante increase down here. I can play the animation slower as well, but again, I don't want these videos already get pretty long, and I don't really want to do that. Reroll surplus, we get basically the rerolls cost $2 less, and that in conjunction with us already having the clearance sale is going to be very nice for our early game economy. The problem is that we have none right now. None to speak of. Remember, we also get the double tag here. This is one of the passives that we have from the Anaglyph deck, which is the one we're playing right now. So voucher, I do like having cheap rerolls. It's a little bit risky because we need to get jokers, but right now it's too good to pass up with reroll surplus and overstock or clearance sale. So we have the handy tag. This is definitely a way for us to get some money, or we could double our money on the economy tag, or just wait. We don't have to burn our double tag right now. As you see here, things start getting pretty difficult and the fish is actually pretty annoying. So, I'm not going to skip handy tag right now. It's $4, but we have 4 hearts here and 2 kings, so I am going to try to maybe get a flush draw. We have an open-ended straight draw now, too, of course. But yeah, we're still going to go for flushes because that's what we're specializing in. We get 3 kings now, but we're still going to play the flushes just because it's actually leveled up higher than our 3 of a kind would. So notice the chips over here. So at the base level, this starts at 300. But you're thinking like, well, yeah, flushes are good. What about trips? Wouldn't that be good? Well, technically, in poker, flushes are better than trips anyway. But as you see here, the base value of this of trip kings starts at 90. However, you have to consider the 30 extra chips that we have here from the enhanced king. So the way the face cards work is that basically these are always worth 10. So these add 10 chips, 10 chips, and then 40 chips. So at the base value, it's 90. This would be 100, 110, and 140 times 3. So what 140 times 3 is roughly 420 chips. I think my math is correct there. But if you look at the base value of flushes, we have a base value of 300, and that's going to be 311, 321, 331, 340 times 6. I'm not going to try to do the math there, but that's going to be worth more, a little bit more than 420. It's not going to be enough to get us out, though. Okay, so we could play two pair here. We probably won't have any more kings. We do still have two kings left, even though we discarded one because we used that other, that spectral card. We can try to go for the boat here. We also have an ace, which is probably going to come up here. But yeah, let's see if we get that king. Two pair. It's not a great hand, but we want to play the king. The jack does have a plus multiplier on it, so we'll just go ahead and play that. And the reason why I'm playing the five is just so we can discard that card in case we needed to draw something extra, even though the five doesn't score here. I mean, mime's not bad. If we get something like Baron, or if we get something like Shoot the Moon or something like that, would be nice. The only problem is that we have nothing in our deck right now that triggers in our hand. We have no steel cards. We have no jokers to do so. But mime can be pretty good. I'm going to preemptively buy mime here, but we're going to be really hurting here in a second. Now we can't use the economy tag because obviously it's just going to make it $8, and it's not even enough to buy a rare joker. Going to be discarding for diamonds. Could go for a boat too. There's still three queens and three kings left. A boat would be more valuable than diamonds. So we can go for royal flush. Okay, but we got the flush, almost a royal flush. This is not going to really be like, it's gonna be difficult here. We need to score 1200. We only have 570. So there's still three queens and still two kings. We're going to try to burn. This is just a throwaway hand. It's a high card of the jack and nothing else scores. Game is not cooperating. I mean, we did get trip kings. We might as well try to go for the gusto here because I think that might be the only way that we're going to get out here. We do get quads. So quad kings will easily get us out, I think. Yeah. But this run is feeling kind of not great. So business card is a good way to get the economy going. However, I love business card. When played, face cards have a 1 in 2 chance to give $2 when scored. I love face card early on. And we have to level up something here. So another common question that I've seen in the comments is that people have been asking, does the pack art matter? No, the pack art does not matter. If it was a jumbo pack or a mega pack, that would definitely, they contain more cards, but this pack art here is just for variety. It doesn't actually have any bearing on what cards are inside of them. So full house, four of a kind, or a pair. We can make some pretty good full house plays here. Full house is a combination of three of a kind and a pair in 1 5 card hand. So now we're going up against the fish though, and this is gonna be rough. I think we should go for either quad kings or go for a full house of kings and queens to help out with business card, but to also try to get out of here. I don't know if we're gonna win this, to be honest. Okay, well, there's our full boat. I'm going to use our last discard to try to maximize this. Okay. This is not going to get us there. I hope it gets us a lot of money though from business card. And it got us $2. See, now the problem with the fish is that we don't know what cards these are. We can infer some clues based on how the sorting goes. So we know that this card is either a 10 or higher. We know that this card is either a 9 or a 10. We know that, we absolutely know that this is a deuce here, because if you see the way that it shuffles, this, there's no other card that's lower than a deuce. This could be a 2 or a 3 or anything above a deuce, but this has to be a 2. But I think we are thoroughly boned though. We got a pair of deuces, look at that. We pretty much just have to play everything that we can't see and hope that we draw into another boat. That was almost a straight. Yeah, Yeah, and that's the problem with the bosses that hide the amount or hide your cards. So I'm gonna do another one because that one was just we never got going in that run, and that's just how it goes for Balotro. We get to start with a Mega Arcana pack. Honestly, I'm fine with that. You get to choose 2 of 5 tarot cards, which can be good. Wild card, 3 of diamonds or steel. These are all pretty bad. Yeah, these are all bad. All bad. I suppose we could go for diamonds. Then we can use the Fool card here if we really wanted to. There is an achievement that allows you to... There is an achievement that allows you to get another Joker if you have 30 diamonds. We're already at 16, so we'll try it. So we got double... We have 2 pair here. We got jacks and threes. Could go for a boat, but honestly, a pair of threes is pretty weak, so I'm just not going to worry about that. And lucky us, we ended up drawing 3 pair, but we did also draw into a straight. So we're just going to go ahead and play that. Actually, before we do that, we can actually turn this to a royal flush, which is a way, way, way better hand. Give me a king. Give me a king. Well, we have to turn one of the 10. We have to turn the 10 into a diamond to get a royal flush. So there is an achievement that if you discard a royal flush. Oh, yeah, I forgot the 9. If you discard a royal flush, that unlocks a Joker. That's right, because we have an ace. This is me talking too much and not paying attention to the game. It's quad sixes. So if you happen to get an early Arcana pack that allows you to turn an ace high flush into a royal flush, if you discard it, you gain a new Joker, which is very, very, very strong. I'm not going to spoil it. So Fibonacci is too good not to have here. Each played ace, 2, 3, 5, or 8 gives +8 multi when scored. Wasteful is fantastic. It is essential to have plus hand size, plus round, or the amount of hands that you can play, or the amount of discards that you can play. But Fibonacci combined with Hack is actually pretty dang awesome. The problem is that we can't take both right now. So I'm going to take Fibonacci. Hopefully we see Hack come back, but right now, yeah, we have to take Fibonacci. All spade cards are debuffed. But luckily for us, we didn't make any spades, so I'm just gonna go ahead and play the flush right now. Well, we don't have to. We can create a better hand here. We just need the ace. We just need the ace and 10. Preferably we need the 10. We need the 10 of diamonds. So those little numbers that you see in the color coded, you see it's purple, red, blue, and brown. Those are the suits, okay? There are 2. If you look under 10, it says 3. That means that there's 3 tens left in our deck. If you look further than that, there's 1 red heart. There's 1 10 of hearts left, and then there's 2 10 of diamonds left in this deck. So we could really shoot the moon and try to go for it. Kind of risky, and we got it. So this is not a royal flush, but this is a straight flush, and that's easily going to be enough. And Scholar. I don't like Campfire. I'm not going to explain why, I just don't like it. Scholar, on the other hand, plus Fibonacci is very strong. Plus hand size is also very, very good, but right now we have no economy, so we need to start getting an economy quick. We haven't used the double tag yet either, which is unfortunate, but we really, really need to get one of those economy ones. Otherwise, we're just dead in the water. So we do get an ace here. Fibonacci scores off of 8s, 5s, 2s, and 3s as well. We did get a pair of 8s. I don't want to discard the queen. I don't really care about the pair of 8s that much because we're looking for a flush here. Got a flush, so let's go ahead and do that. Go ahead and cash that in. You see that just a little bit of plus multiplier is all you need to catch on fire and really start pushing the score. Duo is very good. I don't like Seance that much, although we are creating a lot of straight flushes here because of those plus diamonds. I am going to go for Paintbrush, though. Plus hand size is just really, really, really strong. And then we can't afford anything else. We can get an Arcana pack, I guess. Maybe make some more diamonds. So we have the Magician Strength card, which is going to increase the rank of the card, and then Emperor card. I really like Emperor cards because it gives you value. Just like in Isaac, it helps give you shortcuts to possible wins. So we get a Hermit card, a Fool card. It's money. Yeah, there's no reason for us not to play this here. Get three queens. We actually flopped a full boat. Yeah, I'm not gonna turn that down. It's not gonna get as much score because obviously full house is level one, but it counts as basically a free draw. We have another boat here. We can still maintain a flush draw. Not great. Still two fives, three eights, and four aces left. We should try to go for some fives or eights or aces, because we need to be, especially aces, we need to be throwing hard for aces here. Of course, we're not getting any because, you know, it's a victim luck. We do have three pairs, though, which is not a valid poker hand, but yeah. This is scuffed. I'm gonna hold on to the fives just in case we absolutely need to have fib. And we still have not drawn a single ace. All right. And we still have not drawn a single ace. That is remarkable. Well, we get a Fibonacci full house, which is going to be enough, but all you had to do is just give me an ace game, but that's Invicta luck for you. That's Balatro, baby. Yeah, so we have a decent combo here. We can either use the Hermit card to double our money and then double it again with a Fool, or we can save the Hermit card and go for broke. I do like Hallucination, but it would cause us to lose all of our money. We double now and double again, that'd be $16. Or we can see what's inside of this Arcana pack and then maybe double that with the Fool, which that's what I want to do. Yeah. Not great. Really, really not good. We have no room for an Emperor card right now, so I guess we make more nines. This is all bad. So this is gonna increase them into nines. Turn them into nines. All clubs are debuffed. We absolutely have to play aces here, and there's no if, ands, or buts about it. We're almost at a Fibonacci flush, which would be nice. We want to play the eight and the five instead of the other queen, because this is going to trigger Fibonacci and everything but the king and queen here. We could turn this into an ace as well, the king. Or maybe not. Apparently they didn't count as... Oh yeah, we can use it. Okay. So we might as well make a king and a queen here. Take the king, turn to a a queen. Or take the queen, turn into a king, you know what I meant. There you go. So we have two double tags now, which we still have not been able to use yet. I'm going to use the hermit card now to double our money, because we need money. But we really, this deck also, again, is just, it's, this is just one of those times where we're just not getting a whole lot of support that we can afford anyway. So we really, really, really need to hope for an economic tag or something. We do get another star, which is going to allow us to make more diamonds. Don't know if we're actually going to get there or not for the achievement, but let's see. How many diamonds are we at now? So if you count this number over here, this shows you how many of individual suits you have. So we have 22. We need 8 more diamonds to make it. So I wasn't really planning on achievement hunting right now in this run, but I will buy the turtle bean because this is going to increase our hand size by a whole lot. Coupon tag gives us a bunch of basically a bunch of free stuff, but at this point I feel like we need the economy, so I'm willing to skip it though. We're looking here for, we have the flush, but we want to go big here. So we're getting rid of Fibonacci cards, but I don't care about them right now. We have 2 trips. Trips means 3 of a kind, by the way, if you didn't know. Okay. So we're going to play the boat. It's not a Fibonacci boat, but this should score okay since we leveled up our full houses earlier. A little bit of extra money. Again, these are not really all that great. Might be able to get another stars card. Didn't. We can use the hangman to get rid of some cards that we don't want. 6s and 7s don't do anything for Fibonacci, so I'm going to get rid of them. We can level up something here as well. We have 3 of a kind, straight flush, 2 pair. Give me trips. Okay, so I'm going to skip this because we have the coupon tag. Initial cards and booster packs in the next shop are free. This is only going to activate once. I don't believe that this combos with the double tag. Or maybe it does. We get a whole bunch of free shops if we beat the mark here. All face cards are drawn face down. So we can freely just play these cards just to see what they are. But we have to get to 5,600, and that's quite a lot. Gonna take a chance, though. We do get 2 pair, which is not gonna help us out that much. Okay, so there's our aces. We need aces. We need aces. Getting rid of non-Fibonacci cards is good here. You know this is a face card. Still looking for some good boats. If we could get a 3 and some 5s, that'd be nice for Fibonacci. We could play a Fibonacci boat here. The aces and 3s, and that's probably the best we're going to get right now. Yeah, no problem. All right, and then every single shop on this next floor around or ante are free. We get a free hallucination. I like it. Get ourselves a free devil card. I like it. There we go. A hallucination proc. So hallucination is a joker. 1 in 2 chance to create a tarot card whenever we open a booster pack. And we just got judgment, which gives us a joker. So let's go ahead and use that. And we get walkie-talkie. Doesn't really synergize with anything, but sure. 4 of a kind, flush, or high card. We can go for flushes. I mean, flushes with all the diamonds would be not too bad. It's still early enough for us to get some value out of it. 4 of a kind with aces would be absolutely nuts. I'm not going to re-roll right now, because even if we re-roll, we're not going to be able to afford anything. We don't want to be skipping blinds here at all. Even for the rare Joker, I don't think it's worth skipping because we need to use these coupons. So yeah. Trip threes. I mean, we do have a somewhat Fibonacci boat. It's like a half fib boat, but go ahead and get rid of them. Let's just get rid of them. Okay, almost got us there. It is amazing that we have not found. We could play a straight here, but. Play a flush, but it's not going to get us there. We need to get the aces. We have one discard left. I'm going to keep the eights. So we drew another boat here. So the gold, that gold two, by the way, that we used for the devil card four will give us an extra $2, $3, something like that. As long as we have it in our hand when we're done. So Zany Joker gives us three of a kind. Turtle Bean's almost done. We're not really using walkie-talkie, though, so I'm going to get rid of that. And I will take the... Well, before we take this, let's see what the Buffoon Pack gives us, because I don't want to accidentally take this and then have to get rid of it. The Ride the Bus, plus one multi whenever we have a consecutive hand played without a face card, or we have the Lusty Joker, which is... going to give us multi every time we play a heart. Either one of these are fantastic for us. We've been reducing the amount of hearts in our deck by a whole lot, so the likelihood of us ever playing hearts is very, very low. So I guess Ride the Bus, but we're also just gonna immediately get rid of it for the Zany Joker. Plus what multi, if the played hand contains a three of a kind, that means that the hand that we score with, if it has a three of a kind in it, regardless of what type of hand it is, as long as it scores, is going to give us plus 12 multi. Judgment. Yeah, these are all not great. I'll make a glass ace just in case here. Or we could get rid of the bean. I mean, we're only going to get one more use out of it anyway. I think we can get rid of the bean. Let's roll the dice with judgment here. Not good. Chariot's gonna allow us to create a steel card. And we only have paintbrush, so our build is not great. Shoot the Moon is plus 13 for each queen held in hand, and then also Juggler just gives us one plus one hand size. We might as well take Joker, the Juggler here. I guess we can skip for the rare Joker. It's gonna give us two rare Jokers in the next time we go to a shop. So yeah, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna immediately use, well no, we don't wanna use the steel card yet because we're gonna need that extra card. And we flopped a boat. This is basically an easy discard for us. The order of these don't matter right now. We don't have anything that pings in any sort of order that needs to be cared about currently. But yes, something that people have been trying to get better at has been paying attention to the order of the Joker bench. Right now, again, currently, the order of everything doesn't matter because nothing pings off of each other. You see there, without Fibonacci proccing, we get basically nothing. Oh yeah, we can only score houses. That's right. I forgot we're going up against the mouth. So that makes things a little bit tougher. We can only score with boats. I'm gonna save the threes for when we hopefully inevitably get our aces. We need a two, a three, or an ace. Got our two. I'm gonna make a steel seven since we're not using sevens for anything Fibonacci related. It's gonna give us a times 1.5 multiplier as long as it stays in our hand when we score. This should easily get us there. Oh my goodness. We just got two rare jokers and then both one of the bests in their own rights. So we got baseball card and brainstorm. So this is the joker that you can unlock by discarding a royal flush. As we already talked about in this video, and we saw it, there you go. Brainstorm is fantastic. It's basically like, it's kind of like Blueprint. It basically copies the leftmost ability of the leftmost joker, which is the one that's all the way over here. So obviously we're taking both of these. We cannot get rid of Fibonacci. We cannot get rid of Scholar. Zany Joker's gotta go. Gotta go. And then also Hallucination. I like Hallucination. I like Juggler. I'm gonna get rid of Hallucination and then we'll take both of these. So what we want here is we want to have either Fib or Scholar in the leftmost spot. The baseball card is going to give every uncommon joker 1.5 times multiplier. We only have one. That's Fibonacci. So we're going to be looking at trying to get rid of Juggler. But we cannot get rid of Fibonacci. Scholar, you really don't want to either. We don't have a whole lot of aces as a thing. We only have 5 aces. But right now, Brainstorm is copying Scholar. If I were to put Fibonacci here, it would copy Fibonacci. It's probably best that we... We're going to have to probably flip-flop these a lot, depending on how many aces we have in our hand. These are all bad. All bad. For the flush here. Then we can get reroll surplus again, so we might as well use that. Odd Todd does work well with aces, but we just don't have, we have no use for it here. Man, I love Ballot. I love Hanging Chad. I'm gonna get rid of Juggler. Even though it's not an uncommon joker here, I absolutely love Hanging Chad. It goes very well with Brainstorm, depending on what you have. So now our hand becomes very, very modular. We need to make sure that whatever cards we get dealt are playing into Brainstorm, basically. Yeah, so we can go immediately for a straight or a flush. I love how, by the way, we drew how many of our hearts? We have 10 hearts and we drew 5 of them, but 2 diamonds. Pretty incredible. So let's just see. For S's and G's, let's see what an ace high Fibonacci straight would do with Brainstorm and the multiplier between Fibonacci and baseball card. And also this triggering off of the first card, which is going to be Hanging Chad. So how Hanging Chad works is it re-triggers the first card when used in scoring, which means the furthest left to your hand. So like, for example, if I were to do this, but the ace was like here, Hanging Chad would only trigger off the 5, okay? So Hanging Chad is very position dependent as well. So you need to make sure that our aces are front. Brainstorm is also going to trigger Fibonacci twice here for every Fibonacci card, which is everything but the 4. So I don't know if this is gonna go out, but it should be a decent amount of, points because Hanging Chad's gonna trigger Scholar, which is going to trigger Scholar again and also Fib again. So I don't know, let's see how many points this is worth. Yeah, that's a level 1 straight. Madness is bad. I don't know anyone who can make Madness work. If you have it at the very beginning and you have a lot of money, maybe, but I just don't. Get a Jumbo Celestial pack here, try to level up something good. And we don't, but I guess 3 of a kind. Open a standard pack or re-roll for something cooler. We should be looking for an uncommon joker that isn't Madness, basically. 8 is a Fibonacci. It is a Fibonacci card, so I think we have to go with 8 here. add reroll. And reroll is at the next shop start at zero. It's not worth doubling up for our tag, especially when we're pretty powerful right now. Get the steel card in hand. This is an ace high flush, level 3. I just want to see what this does as well. Blueprint. We actually don't want to trigger Fibonacci twice here. I think it's better for us to get this because this is going to give us plus 8 anyway with Hanging Chad. So let's see what doubling Scholar instead of Fibonacci does here with Hanging Chad and Blue and Brainstorm. Yeah, it's about the same. So these are not super great. Both of these jokers don't have anything to do with what we're going for. I mean, a gold seal deuce that's a lucky card would be great for re-triggering with Fibonacci and stuff. So yeah, so all diamond cards debuffed, which is literally more than half of our deck. So yeah. I'm gonna keep the ace just in case. We can go for a Fibonacci full house here. We want to put the 8 here because it gives us more multi. Oh, actually, no. We get more multi, I think, from Fibonacci scoring multiple times here than the ace. Only reason why I would put the ace there or the 8 there first is because of Hanging Chad, but this actually triggers more. So, I don't know. Let's see. Yeah, we're okay. Scary face is great, but not good here. Superposition, we're not playing straights here, so it's okay, but neither one of these are uncommon, so I don't really care about them. Maybe we get another ace. Not going to turn down another ace here. Not for the fact that we have Scholar. These don't matter. Give me a reroll. I do like the Midas Mask. It isn't uncommon. I really, really like Hanging Chad, but I'm buying Midas Mask only because it's uncommon, because it synergizes with baseball card. We need some scaling really badly here. I really wish that we could just get an economic tag instead of us getting these foil tags and stuff, because right now we have no economy. Hopefully the Midas Mask can help us out. Midas Mask, all face cards become gold when played. It can be pretty good. Drawn 3 pair. Good. I guess the pair of jacks. I mean, they'll turn gold here, so. Brother, just asking for one ace. We got 4 of them left. So we're duplicating Scholar here, I think. No, it doesn't matter. We can duplicate Fib here. And this should be a lot more points now that we've added another uncommon card. Uncommon Joker. Yeah. So it's just those little tiny increases that you can get that are worth a whole lot. We get a Polychrome Wily Joker. The problem is that it's not uncommon. However, it does take the place of what Midas Mask was doing, but I think the Midas Mask honestly is just better for us because this also, there is an achievement that you can get. I'll show you real quick. There's a Joker that you can get where play a five card hand that contains only gold cards, and we might as well try to go for that. So I'm gonna go for the Arcana pack here. Don't get a Stars card. These are not great. I'm gonna increase the multi on aces though. So yeah. And I'm gonna be discarding hard for Fibonacci cards right now and aces. So notice here that Full House, even though Full House is a better poker hand, it is not worth more than a three of a kind is. So three of a kind, 70 times seven, that's a base of 490 versus 65 times six, which is 390. So yeah, it's a difference by 100 points of base value. I'm gonna play the king, so Midas Mask does proc, and I'm also gonna get rid of one of our fours because they're just useless for us. Oh, baby. Okay, so let's see if we can get... I do get a boat, but I really wanted to hold on to my two of clubs, man. That's okay. Again, as you see here, the boat doesn't really matter. I'm going to play the queens and the queen and jack just because, again, Midas Mask. It doesn't matter if they score. We just have to play them. And let's hope that the two of hearts gets us 20 bucks. Give me 20 bucks. Gave us 20 multi, but that's fine. Oh man. Sock and Buskin. Don't have a whole lot of face cards, but man. We could just replace the Midas Mask for Sock and Buskin, because it's not really doing anything for us. And we already got a bunch of gold cards, so. It's like, we cannot get rid of Scholar or Fibonacci. So. Take Sock and Buskin. See if we can get an Arcana pack here. And these are just all not great. Actually, this is an achievement here. If we turn a gold seal card into a gold card, I think we unlock something. This is going to override the lucky, but that's fine. Hey, certificate of authenticity. Nice. Oh, look at that. We got ourselves an unlock. How about that? I'm going to open the buffoon pack just to see what we get. Both of these are pretty bad. First hand is drawn face down. Super. I'm just going to discard these. Well, no, we should probably play them. Don't know if this is an ace or not. It was an ace. So there's a flush. The trips are better than a flush here. We almost have a flush house. Five times eight. It's 520. 520 versus 490. Versus this is going to trigger twice. So it's 630, 6390. The flushes are still going to be the best here. But we really, really, really need to get aces. We only went off of aces here. And we have drawn One of them. But no, we did play the other ones. I think we're pretty much screwed. It was a good run, and we got an unlock, so I'll be happy with that, but this run could have gone definitely a little bit further, so. But yeah, thank you for watching, everyone. Let's take a real quick peek at what we unlocked. That's just how Balotro be, you know? When round begins, add a random playing card with a random seal to your hand. Yo, that sounds pretty dope. I like it. So thank you for watching, everybody. Remember, we're trying to get these videos over 1,000 likes. Make sure you click the like button, leave a comment down below. And again, sorry about the missing video yesterday. It was just YouTube craziness. And yeah, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.